readings today, meditating on it. Today, we have the incredible joy to welcome into the body of Christ Evelyn, and next Sunday, we're celebrating the baptism of Jesus. So what better way to kick off the new year than two baptisms, in a sense, one right after the other. Thank you for this opportunity. With all of that in mind, and so much more, I say Happy New Year and invite you to stand as you are able as we prepare our hearts and minds for worship through an order of confession and forgiveness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us. For his sake, God forgives us all our sins. Through the Holy Spirit, God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin and made us alive together with Christ. By grace, you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in our hearts through faith. Amen. of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Let us pray. Eternal Father, you have given your incarnate Son, the holy name of Jesus, to be a sign of our salvation. Plant in every heart the love of the Savior of the world, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you, Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. First reading may be found in Numbers chapter 6, verses 22 through 27. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to Aaron and his sons, saying, 'Thus you shall bless the Israelites. You shall say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.' So they shall put my name on the Israelites, and I will bless them."
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The second reading may be found in Galatians chapter 4, verses 4 through 7. But when the fullness of time had come, God has sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as children. And because you are children, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a child. And if a child, then also an heir through God. Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. After 8 days had passed, it was time to circumcise the child, and he was called Jesus, the name given by the angel, before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. Had this children's sermon waiting for 2 weeks to be preached, and maybe next week I'll just go ahead and preach it even if there are no kids. Looking forward to retelling the Christmas story through a Mad Lib, but that's what we missed this morning. So I will say Happy New Year. It's 2023, and just as God was present in our lives every year past, God is present now. I pray that this year brings blessings of health and happiness to you and to your loved ones. Last year was full of reminders that this is God's world. And in it, creation is interwoven in ways beyond our understanding to the glory of God. This is God's promise to us, which Mary sings as praise so beautifully in the Magnificat. We read it a couple of weeks ago, but her words are worth repeating and even holding up as our own prayer. Luke chapter 1. Someday you'll be singing the Magnificat. And Mary said, My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel. He remembers his mercy according to the promises he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and his descendants forever. When Evelyn helps us capture the challenge of that prayer, it's not wine and roses, ponies and sunshine. It's complicated because even as Mary sings praises to God and that the hungry will be nourished, Mary notes that the rich will be sent away without receiving anything. So I want to meditate on some of that this morning. I'm sorry Evelyn had to step out for a minute, but she'll be back. But I use that to say Merry Christmas to you. In the church calendar, Christmas begins on December 25th, of course, but you've heard of the 12 days of Christmas. So on January 26th is technically when Christmas ends, with the Feast of Epiphany. So if you need an argument for playing Christmas music or watching holiday movies into January, there you go. Arrival on Earth is a little muddled. There's this Christmas on our calendar every year. And if you've been here for long enough, you know how I am with calendars. Not great. But this day doesn't coincide with the birth of Jesus. It's just a day that we celebrate. It was placed where it is on the calendar for several reasons, but central to them is our human need for something to celebrate when the nights are so long and frigid, when the fruits of our last harvest are beginning to run low, when 1 year has run its course, and we're eager for a new year to begin, hoping for something different, ideally something better in the year ahead. We need this calendar Christmas every year as a people. But the calendar Christmas was never Christ's only day, and that we anchor our church year around preparation for it means that we venerate our Lord and Savior and not the day itself. Even the gifts we give at Christmas are, in theory, material reflections to remind us that God's gift to the world is Jesus, a truly irreplaceable gift. But again, the timeline of Jesus' arrival on earth isn't straightforward. And if we're being faithful to Scripture, it's complicated beyond human understanding. John chapter 1, which we read not only on Christmas Eve and Christmas Day, but we'll read again soon, echoes Genesis chapter 1 to reveal Christ's presence at the dawn of creation. In the beginning was the Word. It's easy to feel a little bit lost in all of this, these creation stories. Or perhaps more to the point, it's not easy to see where we fit in. Here's what the Apostle Paul has to say. From today's reading from Galatians, but when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as children. And because you are children, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, and it cries, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a child. And as a child, an heir. Similarly, in his letter to the Ephesians, Paul writes, Blessed be God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who chose us in Christ before the foundation of the world to be holy and blameless before him in love. He destined us for adoption as his children through Jesus Christ. There it is again, adoption through Jesus. In Jesus, we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of his grace that he lavished upon us as a father. So to paraphrase, God chose us in Christ before the foundation of the world, destining us for adoption as God's children through Jesus Christ. Well, in contrast to this deep understanding, Christians have been tempted to see Jesus as plan B, as though Scripture tells us, however, that Christ, as the Word of God, broke forth into creation from the beginning. The birth of Jesus as a human infant is plan A, the continuation of God's creative forces at work from the beginning. Rather than a diversion from God's original intent, the Christmas story reveals more deeply God's plan through the life Christ spent as Emmanuel, God with us. Jesus is with us as one of us, having come to earth to live as one of us, and beginning his world-changing ministry in his early 30s. So as some of us were joking in the church office this morning as we were turning the lights on and printing the bulletins, 6 days ago, Jesus was born. Today he's 30, and he's striking out into the desert. Next week we'll celebrate his baptism. Muddled indeed, but the plan as it is. Jesus knew the joys and the sorrows that we know, the laughter, the celebrations as a family and as a community, weddings and feasts, worship of God through song and through close reading of the Scriptures. Over the course of the decades here on earth, he knew crying as a baby, which Evelyn demonstrated. Getting bumps and bruises as a toddler, which anyone who's a parent here has seen and worried. Knowing hunger as the child of a poor craftsperson. Mourning losses in life, as we all have, including the death of friends and the sorrow of his nation, occupied as it was by the Roman Empire. But God's plan for this, for Jesus' ministry, for the gift that we receive through Christ's life by God's gift of grace, is prayerfully outlined in the Magnificat, Mary's song. A leveling of our earthly intentions, our arrogance, our self-absorption. It's unending, both across the generations and as we are difficult when we try to live out this work. Indeed, the sacrifices that such a life requires are often reminders that it is God and not we who are truly in control. But Paul's letters to the early Christians, to the people of Galatia and to the people of Ephesus, speak to the same human concerns that we have now. And today we welcome Evelyn Grace Davidson into the body of Christ. We pray upon her God's Holy Spirit. Paul continues in his letter to the Ephesians, "In Jesus, you also, when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and you believed in Christ, were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance toward redemption as God's own people, to the praise of God's glory." That's it. Redemption. Oneness with God for all of creation. That's God's plan. And it's plan A. It's bigger than our human minds can ever encompass, and it's not free from suffering, and it's not without its joys. Christ invites you into this vision, this work, this promise. In 2023, things will be different again. The meaning and purpose of the work is the same, and God is the same. God is with us. And I say, God is with you. And so I offer this prayer to mark the new year. Christ the Word, stir us from our complacency, even as you comfort us with your eternal presence. Christ Emmanuel, move us to the work of peace while we advocate for and do what we may to help the sick, the needy, the broken, and others you sought out in your ministry. And Christ the Healer, take into your hands the health and well-being of our families, our neighbors, and your world. In your holy name we pray. Amen. join me up here, please? That works. All right. In baptism, our gracious Heavenly Father frees us from sin and death by joining us to the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are born children of a fallen humanity. By water and the Holy Spirit, we are reborn children of God and made members of the church, the body of Christ. Living with Christ and in the communion of saints, we grow in faith, love, and obedience to the will of God. Called by the Holy Spirit, trusting in the grace and love of God, do you desire to have your child baptized into Christ? As you bring your child to receive the gift of baptism, you are entrusted with responsibilities to live with her among God's faithful people. Bring her to the Word of God and the Holy Supper. Teach her the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments. Place in her hands the Holy Scriptures and nurture her in faith and prayer, so that Evelyn may learn to trust God, proclaim Christ through word and deed, care for others and the world that God made, and work for justice and peace. Do you promise to help Evelyn grow in the Christian faith and life? Sponsors, do you promise to nurture Evelyn in the Christian faith as you are empowered by God's Holy Spirit, and to help her live in the covenant of baptism and in communion with the church? People of God, do you promise to support Evelyn and pray for her in her new life in Christ? Please stand as you are able. I ask everyone gathered here this morning to profess your faith in Jesus Christ, to reject sin, and to confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God? I renounce them. Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God? I renounce them. Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God? I renounce them. Do you believe in God the Father? I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit? The Lord be with you. Let us give our thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life into which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family. And through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river your Son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you set us free from the power of sin and death and raise us up to live in you. Pour out your Holy Spirit, the power of your living word, that those who are washed in the waters of baptism may be given new life. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated. Will Evelyn please join me? You're going to get a little wet. It's okay. Evelyn Grace Davidson, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit, you gave your daughters and sons new birth. You cleansed them from sin and raised them to eternal life. Sustain Evelyn Grace with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Evelyn Grace, child of God, you have been marked by the Holy Spirit and sealed by the Holy Spirit and marked with the cross of Christ forever. Amen. This is fun to look at, isn't it? That's right. Evelyn, let your light so shine before others that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Let us welcome the newly baptized. We welcome you into the body of Christ and into the mission we share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and bearing God's creative and redeeming word to all the world. You may be seated.
In gratitude and humility, let us join together in prayer on behalf of all God's creation. For all the baptized, that they become skilled in compassion and grace and equipped to share the good news with all. Grant your followers persistence in proclamation and prayer. Hear us, O Lord. For air and sky, clouds and sun, that they provide rain to parched land and relief to flooded ground. Renew and restore our polluted atmosphere and empower us to be worthy stewards of creation. Hear us, O God. For judges, juries, and all who work in the judicial system, that they desire wisdom, seek truth, rule with fairness, and have the courage to do what is right. Eliminate oppression and injustice in our criminal justice system. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
For all who are lonely, especially those who have newly arrived in an unfamiliar city or country, political prisoners without recourse to justice, hospital patients without visitors, and any who are ill or grief-stricken. We pray for the family of Carol, Helen, Shirley, Josh, and family, Linda, Jane, Amy Ann, and family, Kathy, Michelle, Tom, Shirley, and family, Russ and Kathy, Kinsey, Mindy, Vivian, Xavier, Mark, Donna, Charlie, Dan, Shell, Dalton, Charlotte, Marge, and Tom. Hear us, O God. For those in our congregation and community engaged in advocacy work, that with persistence of the widow, they lift their voices in seeking justice on the behalf of others. Hear us, O God. For those who have taught us in faith and now rest in your heavenly peace, that we remember and give thanks for these saints who shared the gospel through word and deed. Hear us, O God. With grateful hearts, we commend our spoken and silent prayers to you, O God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
God is a community of Christ. Through our live stream and through our recordings, we are also able to extend our worship service to include virtual participants. So this morning, to everyone gathered here and to any who may be watching or listening, I say, the peace of the Lord be with you. Please greet your neighbor. Holy God, gracious and merciful, you bring forth food from the earth and nourish your whole creation. Turn our hearts toward those who hunger in any way, that all may know your care. And prepare us now to feast on the bread of life, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. In the wonder and mystery of the Word made flesh, you have opened the eyes of faith to a new and radiant vision of your glory, that beholding the God made visible, we may be drawn to love the God whom we cannot see. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Thank you.
Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Before us this feast, the body and blood of your Son. By your Spirit, strengthen us to serve all in need, to give ourselves away as bread for the hungry. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Well, let's welcome once again, by a sign of acclamation, Evelyn Grace Davidson into the body of Christ. Very excited for her and for her family. I understand that there is cake. Thank you very much for bringing that. And so please, if you're able, join in for some coffee and cake following worship. Are there other announcements for the benefit of the community? Well, Happy New Year. Invite you to stand as you're able.
Bring forth, Lord.
May God fill us with the wonder and openness of Mary, the righteousness and kindness of Joseph, the eagerness of the shepherds, and the determination of the Magi at the coming of Emmanuel. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever.
Amen.
Go in peace to worship and honor the newborn King. Thanks be to God.